Angela with Little Red River Soap Company, and I'm getting ready to make a coffee soap today that I found a recipe on Brambleberry. It's not going to be exactly that recipe, but it'll be close. So we're gonna get busy here and make, I'm calling it Colombiana because I'm using Colombian beans, and they're ground. They have, the soap is actually going to have some coffee grounds in it as a exfoliant, so that'll be really nice. I'm using Brambleberry's Espresso fragrance, and I'm using cocoa powder instead of brown colorant. I'm going to be using activated charcoal instead of black colorant, and I will be using just a little bit of titanium dioxide. So I guess we will get started. I'm going to melt my coffee butter because I'm super fat with coffee butter today, and I need to melt it down a little bit. But we are within 10 degrees of one another. This one is 98, and my coffee water, which instead of using water, I used strong French press coffee. And this has Tussa silk in it. And I also this time added just a little bit of sodium lactate to, it's a milk byproduct, to help with the hardening so that we get a little bit harder bar that makes it last a little longer. So it's the first time I've tried it. So yay! Anyway. So let's get started. Let's give this a little stir here. I'm gonna try to pay attention to where the camera is. I kind of have a problem with that sometimes, so I forget. Oh, I think I maybe should have used my bigger bowl. Give it a little stir here. Okay. Let's do our stick. Here we go. And I just want to get this to emulsification because I do want to do a pretty hanger swirl. And if I over stir it, it will get too thick, too fast. So okay, that looks really good. And I'm gonna add my, I think I'm going to wait to add that until I'm ready to put it in the individual, after I get it in the individual containers, because I just don't trust it. Oh, let's do our super fat. Yay, coffee butter. I'm doing an 8.5% super fat, so this will be really moisturizing. Stir that the rest of the way by hand. You can hear my dryer running. Okay, let me get my scale. See if I can do this without making a humongous mess. I got oil on my scale earlier. Okay, in one, the black is going to be black. I'm putting 300 mil. Tear it out. Okay, take this out and redo it. It's a neat thing with it being able to do its own tear. So 300 mil. Oops, a little over. Okay, that was like 320 something. And this one, we need 600 mil. This one's gonna be the brown one. $5.98. Ooh. $6.01. Okay. Now, primary one is going to be this one, which will be tan. So, I wasn't going to add any colorant at all to this base, but it's such a little bit too dark, and I'm going to be adding cocoa powder to this other one here to make it a little bit darker. So, I need a little more contrast, so I got this out. Just in case, I got my titanium dioxide ready. So it's probably gonna choke on me here because I just mixed it. And I have such trouble with this stuff plugging up on me. Yep. Well, let's try it another way. Okay, don't wanna add too much. I want it tan. And to this, I'm going to be adding my 2 tablespoons of coffee grounds. They're pre-wetted and they've had, I use them to make the actual coffee that's the base in this. So I've been wanting to try a really nice coffee soap for a long time because it just seems like it would be so amazing to get in the shower when you're half asleep in the morning, getting ready to get up for your day and have a cup of coffee in your soap. It does have caffeine because the coffee was caffeinated and it has, so it'll be in the soap as well. Okay, there's that one. This one is going to be brown and I'm gonna be doing it with regular old cocoa powder. I'm not quite sure how much to add because this isn't light colorant, and I was going to do it in an oil, but cocoa powder acts so weird, and I want it quite dark. So that's about 3 tablespoons. Probably going to wish that I'd used a whisk on this instead of this spatula, but I'll just use my stick blender there when I get ready to put my fragrance oil in. Because yes, it's a wee bit chunky. Oh, that's a really nice deep brown. Good. This might be a little too dark. I may have to add a little bit more titanium dioxide to it. Boy, I had an episode this morning. I've never had it happen before. I was going to get ready to make this soap, and I'd made the espresso coffee, and everything was going along swimmingly, and I cooled off my coffee and everything, but I didn't check it to make sure it was below, I don't know, 100 or something. It was a little warmer than room temperature, and when I added my lye, it foamed over, exploded everywhere. And I was just really grateful that I didn't get any in my eyes or whatever. I was using my safety gear. I got a little tiny burn on my arm because, I mean, it was boiling instantly. But I had a mess to clean up. And that was really upsetting. Add a little bit more. This activated charcoal is just so great for your skin and for purifying your pores. Look at it, a really black. There we go. Looks good. Okay. And before I go any further and add my fragrance oil, I'm going to go ahead and add a little more titanium dioxide. I got black stuff on my bottle. I do that a lot. I'm not exactly the most tidy soaper. I don't know if you can tell how much different that is, but it is in fact significantly lighter. Okay. mess here. And I'm going to add my fragrance, so let's hope it doesn't thicken up on us too much. Let's see, I've got, yeah, about 3.5. Actually, this is closer to 4 ounces weight. You don't have to be perfect with your amounts of fragrance that you're putting in here, because it's all going in the same soap, and you're really not going to be able to tell which color has more fragrance than the other. So anyway, I've heard great things about the espresso fragrance, that it performs well and that it doesn't rise or do other nasty, ugly things. All right, I'm gonna stick blend this really quick here so I can get my cocoa. Scrape off my stick blender or anything before I put it in this black to give it a quick buzz, because the black is a lot darker and that little bit is not going to really make a big difference. No, this cocoa powder is not being eaten by us. This is something, there's a little gnat. This is something that I bought just for soaping, so I could be really, you know, use natural ingredients and go away. I don't know where that little tiny bug came from. I know so many people that are just looking for a healthy, natural alternative to all of the artificial colors and artificial fragrances and everything. And while this particular fragrance is an artificial fragrance, I think it does come from a reputable company that I trust. So, all right. Let's start molding. I always notice that the activated charcoal, no matter what I put in it, it does tend to thicken a bit. So kind of gotta be aware of that. And I'm holding it up higher because I kind of want it to go deep. Cocoa powder's thickening up too. That's the one thing about using natural stuff, is it gets busy. Goodness, it's really doing its thing. Acceleration. A little bit more. Looks like I'm gonna have a little left over. Okay, I'm gonna do a really fun topping on this one, and it's gonna have, you can see this, it's a grated, another coffee soap I made before that was white on the top and coffee on the bottom, and I sprinkled some gold mica in it, and that is going to be my topping. Oh, you know what? I forgot to do my hanger swirl. Let me do that. I would be really bummed out if I didn't get that in there. Actually, gosh, I don't know, that's really full. I might put just a tiny bit of this so I can get a little bit more contrast in my little design that you're probably not going to even see anyway, but let's try this again. Can't believe I almost forgot that. Show you what this looks like if you're not able to see it really, really well yet, if I can pick it up without dropping. Okay. And next, tighten my bolts a little bit here. Okay. Move this over a tad. that's about all I'm gonna do on here. I'm gonna have to poke them down in as it is. Don't want to have a whole lot of loose pieces that are gonna fall off as soon as I unmold it. Tuck them down in there a little bit, maybe they'll stay put. Okay, I'm gonna call that good. I don't know if you can see what this looks like. The light is really a challenge in this kitchen, so. I'm gonna tidy up and I'm gonna put it up and I will come back tomorrow or Monday, this is Saturday. If it's ready tomorrow, then tomorrow I shall unmold and cut. But thanks for watching and for sticking with us. This is Angela with Little Red River Soap Company, and you can find me currently Little Red River Soap Company at gmail.com. One of these days I may have a website. Thanks for watching. Bye. Thank you. This is Angela and Mills with Little Red River Soap Company, wishing you a lovely Sunday and hoping that you'll come back and visit us again one of these days soon. You can buy our soaps. Write to me at littleredrivershow@gmail.com. Thanks. Bye.